Here we go with another Scars of Mirrodin Besiege for 3-2-2, jumping into the first pack, and hey, some good cards. Blight Widow, certainly fantastic, probably one of the best commons in the Mirrodin Besiege, but Victory's Herald, quite a colour commitment there with triple white, but it's quite worth it. It's a bomb that wins the game. As much as I do like Blight Widow, which is less of a colour commitment, but when the power level is that disparate, I mean, it's a bit hard to compare it. But, you know, I'm not too unhappy committing to white. There's lots of white colour committed cards that get passed because people, they don't want to commit. I mean, you'll see Sky Hunters going a bit later than the card would be going if it weren't such a colour commitment. So, here we are in the second pick, and well, we've got some options. Divine Offering, obviously a card there. Sky Hunter is fine too, and Peace Rider is good. If I was going the creature option, I think Sky Hunter is going to be stronger than Peace Rider. So I'd probably put the pick between Sky Hunter and Divine Offering here. Not very excited about anything else in this pack. So, between Sky Hunter and Divine Offering is actually quite tough. I mean, I know Sky Hunter is going to be good, regardless of the matchup. Divine Offering, well, generally don't have too much trouble picking up the artifact removal when you're in white, but flyers are a premium, so I'm going to rate the flyer just a little bit higher here. So, here we got a tough pick. Well, not necessarily a tough pick. Green white, not the most exciting of color combinations. But the only other option there, I mean, I would like to have a deck where I take quite a few flyers early on, especially the Sky Hunters, and then pick a copper carapace a bit later to go with those flying creatures, but can't take it this early. Not against a Blight Widow. There's not much else going on in the pack. Virulent Wound is okay-ish, and then there's Quicksilver Geyser is fine. Phyrexian Rager is good if you're in black. And the rest very, very unexciting. But Blight Widow, it's just that good of a card. You can't really pass it up. So here we've got some decisions. Spread the Sickness here in this pack. Does make decisions a bit harder, because black-white, generally not very good to pair together, just because of the colour commitments, but when you're looking at a pack like this, you can't justify passing a Spread the Sickness. I mean, the only other option would be Sphere of the Suns, but between Spread the Sickness and Sphere of the Suns, I'm not passing Spread the Sickness. I'm not passing the removal for the Fixer. Sorry. So, you know, it spreads me quite awkwardly here, but we'll deal. So, here we've got, well, we're looking at Divine Offering and Peace Strider again. I don't think Rotwolf is necessarily an option, not when I've got black and green split, but I definitely know I'm going to be in white. I think I'd rather just go with the white card, and Divine Offering is a fine card. I think Divine Offering is better than Peace Strider here. Alrighty, so Viridian Emissary could be an option. Helps with the mana a little bit. He's certainly a fine aggressive creature, because he generally gets through unblocked. And that paired up with the fact that if I was looking at splashing Spread the Sickness, say, I would be able to do that easier. The other options are Partisan, I'm not really excited about, but it is on colour to white. And Blade Sentinel, again, not very exciting. Rusted Slasher could be good, but I think I'm going to go with the Emissary here. And here we go, here's another Sky Hunter, which I'm happy to take. So, as I was saying before, with the colour commitment, I'm not afraid of committing to white from the first pick. Just because you tend to see these double white cards coming around a bit. Yeah, nothing really else is going to tempt me over the Sky Hunter. Again, Rusted Slasher without cast combo with it necessarily. Although white doesn't make it too hard to combo with. But Sky Hunter, just much better. So, now, if we're going to go into green, if we are looking to go into green, then Pistol Strike's obviously the pick for the sideboard here. If we're going to go into black, then Phyrexian Rager is going to be the better. So the question is, which is better, green or black, as it stands? I think green-white is going to be generally a better pairing. Although, black does have Spread the Sickness in it. So, I think I'm going to go with Phyrexian Rager, even though it might not make the main deck. Just because Phyrexian Rager, if I am in black, it's going to be a main deck card, versus if I'm going to be in green, taking the sideboard card. And especially since I'm not going to be too worried about Flyer, since here we go with another one. So, as I was saying, late Sky Hunters. Good value. Now this Peace Strider, on the other hand, shouldn't be going this late, because, I mean, it's good. This is the kind of card that should be getting snapped up as soon as cards like, your bombs, your removal like Spread the Sickness, your good cards like Blight Widow, after those have gone, then you want to be picking up Peace Striders. So, don't know why that's still there. Here, nothing really to take. I definitely don't want to be playing Ardent Recruit in any deck ever. Not even casual ones. So, let's just take this Metallic Mastery, sure. Why not? And Time Trike. It flies, I guess, but let's just take Concussive Bolt instead. And sure, Oculus, why not? Alright, Bladed Sentinel. Certainly a card that's playable. I mean, it's not very good, but playable. So, I'm fine getting a playable card last, although I would prefer to cut it from the deck if there's better cards. So, hopefully some better signals in this next pack as to whether to go, well, okay, whether to go into black or green. So black would have been a strong indicator after I'd taken Skin Render. I would have taken Skin Render if it weren't for this ridiculous bomb right there. And gone into black over green, but I'm not going to complain about the sword here. I mean, sword is going to be pretty ridiculous in pretty much any deck you throw it into, but throwing Sword of Body and Mind onto a flyer is just that much more ridiculous. I mean, it's suddenly you're attacking with a 4/4 flyer. Their protection's not irrelevant. So your green reach guys won't be able to block, your blue flyers won't be able to block. You're going to get blockers pumped out, and if you're not killing by damage first, the mill will get there as well. So, sword. I think sword might actually complete my full complement, so now I will have drafted with every mythic in Scars of Mirrodin Besieged, except for Koth. So, with regards to the question about black or green, I think Grasp of Darkness might answer that for me. Of course, double black, not really ideal with double white and double black cards, but nonetheless, if I can keep my double white cards early and my double black cards later, of course you don't need a Grasp of Darkness early in the game, so I'll keep my white mana sources are higher than the black sources, and it should all work out of the wash. So we'll take Grasp of Darkness here and hide these green guys. Wow, back-to-back Volition Rains, that would have been quite nice. But instead, we're looking at either Moriok Replica, Perilous Mirror. Seriously, back-to-back Volition Rains, that's crazy. And Grand Architect. So, between Moriok Replica and Perilous Mirror, I think I might be more inclined to Moriok Replica, seeing as how my two drops are already fairly sorted, as much as I do like Perilous Mirror. Although, can I really pass out Perilous Mirror? I mean, I guess even if Peril Smear isn't that aggressive, he's just all around solid. I can't really fault it. I don't think I can really pass it. I don't think there's any real reason to pass a Perilous Mirror. I mean, it's just good. Alrighty, so here we've got Edge Right, which I'm just not going to take. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 out of X so far. Coppermere, again, Coppermere is not going to accelerate me into anything, really. Well, Tangaquad, on the other hand, you never know when you might need a wall. I think that's going to be the best bet out of this pack. But I'll go ahead and hide it, because I won't necessarily need it in the main deck. Wow, this pack is pretty dead for playables. Disperse, I guess, is playable. Not very exciting. Panic Spell Bomb. Invisimancer, Borderline. I mean, I can't say that I've had many decks where Invisimancer has made it into the deck. Usually ends up in the sideboard for something better. But the rest, total crap. So, I guess I'll take this Fugitive Distraction. I mean, it's going to sit straight in the sideboard as soon as I take it. But, you know, with all these low drop beaters, it could have a place. So, Lenormir, on the other hand, even though it doesn't accelerate me per se into much, it adds Black Mana, which is quite relevant. Not much else going on, Chrome Steed. Terribly unexciting when you haven't got that many artifacts. Passing all these good blue cards. So Sun Chaser, we're not gonna get going for Metalcraft, and I prefer to steer clear of Metalcraft anyway, so let's have a look at those green cards again. I think Razor Verge Thicket might be a choice, because Oriok Replica, I'm not going to miss either way, having in the deck, but Razor Verge Thicket, I could certainly get some value out of. Not a lot. But I think, yeah, just enough that, I mean, it doesn't cost me anything putting Razor Verge Thicket in, and that could give me options on the green front. Ooh, didn't want to hide him. So if I wanted to side in these anti-flyers with Blight Widow and Wall of Tanglecord and activations, I'd be able to do that without costing anything to my mana base. But I'm going to go back and hide this Blight Widow. So, nothing here. Let's just kick a Spell Bomb, sure. Wow, that's a late Mirrorsmith. That's crazy. Yeah, not terribly excited about playing it at this stage, but I'm going to pass up a card like that. And none of these cards do anything, but maybe I'll just take the rare, because I'm definitely not going to take two Fjordan Distractions. I mean, if you take enough crappy rares in drafts, maybe it'll eventually add up to a ticket. Maybe. Missouri's Archers. If I come across a deck that, you know, I really need the fly hate for. I can't see it happening. Especially not when I shouldn't have too much problems with flyers, with the number of flyers I've already got. And Reaver, sure. Might even end up playing Reaver, who knows. As far as a 3-2 beater, hey. Can't get too far wrong. So, War of Tanglecord, I mean, there is argument for playing it now. Just up artifacts with Mirrorsmith and, you know, lock up the board on the ground and then get in with your flyers. Even if you've got Infect beating in against you, War of Tanglecord will take at least 3 hits to come down. And that's never irrelevant. Shouldn't have too many problems against an Infect deck. With Perilous Mirror, Wall, Phyrexian Rager, those kinds of things, while I get in with my flyers. So, here we have got. So, Rusted Relic is fantastic, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, not enough artifacts to get going just yet. Perilous Mirror. I could see myself playing Perilous Mirror, and then I really wouldn't have much reason to play this Wall of Tanglecord. Silvok Lifestar gives flyers extra power, but that seems incredibly underwhelming. Spellbomb. Let's not go with the green option. Let's go with Perilous Mirror. Another Perilous Mirror is going to be fine. Sitting back on the defense, Perilous Mirrors are fantastic, and even if he's just hitting in for one, that's fine too. But yeah, pumping up the Mirror Smith. Perilous Mirror is very, very rarely a dead card. So let's hide this Wall of Tanglecord. Can't see a need for it anymore. And Revoke Existence is a fine removal card. No need. Well, Mill Galvanizer would be cute. And all with my three Mirror that I already have. But I think I'm just going to go with the removal over the cute card. Although, if Galvanizer tables, I'm going to snap on it. Yeah. 2-2 Perilous Mirror. For the win. Okay, so Trigon of Rage is another aggressively costed artifact, and certainly I could get the beats on with my dudes. So Perilous Mirror plus Trigon of, like, Perilous Mirror or Sky Hunters plus Trigon of Rage. That's a beating. Other option is Gold Mirror. I think Trigon of Rage is going to be better than Gold Mirror. I mean, adding white is nice and all. Getting to double white. But I think Trigon of Rage could get my aggro beats together. Not the worst if you have to sit on defense as well. Well, I mean, if you're looking at cards like Blight Widow on the other side of the table, nothing like a Trigon of Rage to help you bash on through. So, here there's not a lot going on. Flesh Allergy could be a card. Certainly to Flesh Allergy, tossing my Perilous Mirror. Well, I've got plenty of these low 2 drops. And yeah, it's removal that could get rid of a big threat. So I think that's what I'm going to go with here. Bleak Coven, not very exciting. I don't really want to rely on Metalcraft with a low count of artifacts. Yeah, I'm going to go with Flesh Allergy. Alright, Necrogen Scudder I'm very happy with. It's a beating, and he's foily in the air. Otherwise, I'd probably be taking Necrogen Sensor. Not much way to get extra value out of Sensor. Certainly not going to be recurring it, but, you know, play the Sensor, get a Mirror with Mirror Smith, maybe. Seems a bit subpar. Once you're recurring Necrogen Sensor with Glint Hawks, then I would be very happy with the damages. Alright, so I guess you take another Nihil Spellbomb, because certainly this Copper Mirror is going to do pretty much nothing, and Drosshopper is going to be terrible as well. But Nihil Spellbomb, I mean, it cycles away itself. And it's an artifact, so gets Mirror Smith going. That's about all I have to say. And the rest, yeah, not much in that pack. Alrighty, so, wow, that's a late Sizzbarra. Nice for someone, but yeah, Glinthawk Idol. Flies for the win. So that'll bring my fly count up. Yeah. Plus one, it's an artifact. Activates Mirror Smith. And generally going to be better than Clone Shell. Although I do love Clone Shell. Glinthawk Idol is just going to be better for this deck, I would say. Alrighty. So, Sunspear, another 2-drop. Not really what this deck is looking for. Aureok Replica seems like a 2-drop that costs 3 mana. Which is, again, not terribly exciting. Number of equipment is just sort of body and mind. So not likely to get first strike and life link. So, I guess I take Replica. I'm certainly not tempted to take the Wayfarer, though, because Aureok Replica does about the same job as Wayfarer. But also gets the beats on as well. Sure, I'll take a Necrogen Sensor, why not? Let's go ahead and hide this. Seize the initiative. Seeing as how we're going with the low drop thing, probably going to be better than Trigon Amending. Trigon Amending is not even going to be worth sideboarding in with this deck, because if the game goes long, unless I draw a huge bomb, gaining life is not going to help. Sure, let's take a Wayfarer here. Never a shortage of Wayfarers, and a Blisturub. So, I mean, that worked out alright, but the thing is, just this level of flyers is just so good in this format. As long as you've got some removal to back it up and a few bombs as well. Yeah, aggressively costed flyers, very, very powerful. As we shall see. So, and certainly we have got the bombs here as well. Now let's have a look at colours. So, yeah, the colour worked out okay. I've only got two double black cards, and they're both removal. So I'm not too unhappy about the black-white split for colours. So, Divine Offering, Revoke Existence, and Mirrorsmith. And here we've got Grasp of Darkness, Scudder, Rager, Allergy, Spread the Sickness, and Morak Reaver might come in as well, but let's have a look at what else we've got. Letamir I'm still fine with. Sword. Bladed Sentinel? Might go with Bladed Sentinel. Seeing as how it's not really costing me that much by being a 4-drop, and hey, you know, Vigilance. it's got toughness. That's the relevant thing here. And seeing as how I haven't got much else going on in the late drops, so yeah, Perilous Mirror. Bring on the Perilous Mirrors. What else? So Fulgent Distraction might be a consideration, maybe. I think I do want this Moriarchal Reaver, just to keep the curve going aggressive. As far as combat tricks, I might like to have one combat trick, so Seize Initiative as a single combat trick seems okay. Just so that I've got that flexibility, that option. And then I want one more card. Blistergrub. Maybe I'll just go with Spellbomb. So it's going to be between, I guess, Wall, Spellbomb, Replica, Blistergrub. Blistergrub's just going to stay in the sideboard. Let's be clear. Fulgent Distraction, I'm not sure about. Just tapping down creatures is so underpowered. It's good in a race situation, but I don't want to go with it. Nihil Spellbomb is a card that kind of does nothing, but except for activates Mirrorsmith and cycles. And Replica, well, it's just, well, I've got 13 creatures, so maybe Replica's okay. It's an artifact, it's a creature. I guess that's good enough. Alrighty, 10-7 seems good to me. Piles by color. Yep, 10-7 sounds fine. And let's go with this.